Now we will study simultaneous type analog to digital converter. So in this method, number of comparators are used. What is comparator? Comparator is nothing but an operational amplifier having two inputs, inverting and non-inverting. So the analog input voltage, which is to be compared with the reference voltage, is given, the analog input voltage is given to one input of each comparator, and a fixed voltage, which is called as a reference voltage, it is applied to another input of the comparator. The comparator will compare the applied input voltage, which is applied to one input, with the fixed reference voltage. Okay, and it provides high output when the input voltage is more than the reference voltage. There are two types of comparators, inverting and non-inverting. Here, in this simultaneous type analog to digital converter, here three comparators are used, and these comparators are non-inverting type comparators, because if the input voltage, analog input voltage, is greater than or more than the reference voltage, then the comparator will be turned on and it provides high output. Okay, so there is one voltage divider of four equal resistors, resistive voltage divider consisting of four equal resistors, to provide a standard reference voltage, which is called as a reference voltage. So here three reference voltages are taken from the voltage divider. So since there are four resistors, 1, 2, 3, 4, therefore voltage is divided equally across each resistor. That is, voltage across each resistor is, voltage across each resistor is V by 4. So here, with respect to ground, at this point, the voltage across this R is V by 4. Then, with respect to ground, the voltage across this point, it is V by 2. V by 4 plus V by 4. V by 4 plus V by 4, that is V by 2. Okay. Then, the voltage across this point is V by 4 plus V by 4 plus V by 4, that is 3V by 4. Thus, three reference voltages are taken, and these reference voltages are applied to one input of each comparator. And analog input voltage, which is to be compared, it is applied to one input of each comparator. Okay. So this is a simultaneous analog to digital converter. This is a 2-bit simultaneous type analog to digital converter. There are two bits, A and B, and therefore we require three comparators, because there is a formula 2 raised to n minus 1. So n means the number of bits. So 2 raised to 2 minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, is equal to 3. So here three comparators are used. Okay, in case of a 3-bit simultaneous analog to digital converter, we will require 7 comparators, because 2 raised to 3 minus 1. So 2 raised to 3 means 8. So 8 minus 1, that is 7. So we will require 7 comparators in case of 3-bit simultaneous type analog to digital converter. Okay, so this analog voltage is in between V 0 and plus V. This analog input voltage is between 0 and plus V. Now, since these are non-inverting type comparators, if the analog input voltage is slightly greater than the reference voltage, then that comparator will turn on, or it provides high output. So if the input voltage is between 0 and v by 4, then all these comparators will remain off. All these comparators will remain off if the analog input voltage is between 0 and v by 4. But if the analog input voltage is greater than 0 by greater than v by 4, greater than, that is, if the input voltage is between 0 and if the analog input voltage is in between 0 and v by 4, then all comparators remain off. That means these comparators provide low output. So if the input voltage is 0 to v by 4, then all these comparators remains off. That means they provide low output. Okay. Now if the input voltage, analog input voltage, is greater than v by 4, if it is slightly greater than v by 4, but it is less than v by 2, that is, if the analog voltage is in between v by 4 and v by 2, then comparator C1 is high. The comparator C1 is high. That is, this comparator's output goes high. Output of comparator C1 is high and other remains low. That is, C1 is high and C2 and C3 are low. Okay. Now, if the analog input voltage is between is between V by 2 and V by 3 V by 4, V by 2 and 3 V by 4. That is, if the analog input voltage is greater than V by 2, if the analog input voltage is greater than V by 2 and less than 3 V by 4, then the comparator C2 and C1 are high. The output of comparator C1 and output of comparator C2 will be high, and output of C3 will be low. Output of C3 will be low. See here, if the input voltage is between V by 2 to 3 V by 4, means if it is greater than V by 2 and it is less than 3 V by 4, then the comparator C1 and comparator C2 goes high, and C3 goes low. Now, if the input voltage is between 3 V by 4 to plus V, means the input analog input voltage is greater than 3 V by 4 and less than or up to V, then all these comparators output goes high. That is, C1 is high, C2 is high, and C3 is also high. Okay. And then these outputs of these comparators are then fed to the encoding device. The encoding device, the encoding network provides digital output. It provides digital output, and these bits are then stored into the register. It is stored into the register, which consists of flip-flop, constructed from flip-flop. It is a register into the, or these bits are then stored into the register. Okay. So this is about the simultaneous analog to digital converter. Then we will see the advantages. So it is simple in construction, the simultaneous analog to digital converter. It is simple for construction, and its conversion rate is fast, extremely fast, or extremely high conversion rate. So it is also called as flash converter. Then what is the disadvantage? The disadvantage of simultaneous analog to digital converter is large number of comparators are required. Large number of comparators are required. Therefore, the system becomes bulky and also costly. Therefore, more than 3 bits simultaneous analog to converters are not used because more comparators will be required. Okay, so we will stop here.